Quadratic formula, missing terms. If a term is missing, we will use 0 in the quadratic formula. Just as a quick reminder, our formula is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. In our first example, notice that we have the equal sign here and that our 2x term is on the other side from our squared term. So we want to move that over to the other side. And I'll do that by subtracting 2x from both sides. So I now have 5x squared minus 2x equal to 0. We have our a term is our squared term, so that will be 5. Our b term is going to be negative 2. It's always going to be the x. And our c term will be 0. So when I plug this into the formula, I get a negative 2 plus or minus the square root of negative 2 squared minus 4 times our a, which is 5, times our c, which is 0, all over 2 times our a, which is 5. Now, because in the second part our c was 0, this whole thing is just goes to 0. So we can just ignore that. So we're going to get 2 plus or minus the square root of negative 2 squared, which would be 4, all over 10. So now I have 2 plus or minus the square root of 4, which would be 2, all over 10. So 2 plus 2, which is going to give me 4 over 10, which will reduce down to 2/5. And then we have 2 minus 2 over 10, which will just be 0. So my two solutions are 2/5 and 0. Let's take a look at example 3. In this one, we have everything on one side already. So we want to identify our a, b, and c. Our a is always going to be the x squared term. So that will be 3. Our b is always the x term, which means in this case, there isn't one, so it'll be 0. And our c is always the constant, which would be negative 51. So I've got negative b, which is 0, plus or minus the square root of 0 squared, minus 4 times our a, which is 3, times our c, which is negative 51, all over 2 times our a, which is 3. So this is going to simplify down to plus or minus the square root of our 0, of course, is gone. And we have 4 times 3 times negative 51, which will give us 612, all over 2 times 3, which would be 6. Now, I don't know if I can take the square root of 612, but I'm going to try. And I get approximately 24.7 and so on. I'm going to simplify this out. 612, I think, is divisible by 4. So let's start there. And that would give me 153. And 153 will be divisible by 9. which would leave me 17. So I've got plus or minus the square root of 4 times 9 times 17 all over 6. Well, 4 times 9 is 36, and the square root of 36 will be 6. So we get plus or minus 6 square root 17 over 6, which means this will reduce down to plus or minus the square root of 17. So now let's go on to our other examples here. In example 3, again, we do not have everything all on one side, so I want to move that over. So I get 5x squared minus 23 equal to 0. So that means my A term equals 5. We do not have a B term, because remember that our B is our X term. And we have a C of negative 23. So when I put that into our equation, we have negative B, which would be 0, plus or minus the square root of B squared, minus 4 times our A, times our C, all over 2 times our A. So now, this is going to simplify down to plus or minus the square root of 460 all over 10. 460, I cannot take the square root of that, but I can simplify it. I know that it's divisible by 4. So if I divide that by 4, I get 115. And 115 is not going to give me anything else that will simplify. So I've got plus or minus the square root of 4 times 115 all over 10. I can take the square root of 4 out, which would be 2. So I have plus or minus 2 times the square root of 115. All over 10. 2 and 10 have a common factor of 2. So that means we get plus or minus the square root of 115 all over 5. Or look at example 4. So again, on this one, we're missing our B term. We have that A is equal to negative 2, B equals 0, and C equals 31. So this looks like 0 plus or minus the square root of 0 squared minus 4 times our A times our C all over 2 times our A. So that'll simplify down to plus or minus the square root of 248 all over a negative 4. 248 is going to be divisible by 4. And it's going to give me 62. 62 is not going to give me anything, though, that I can take the square root of. So we're just going to have plus or minus square root of 4 times 62 all over negative 4. Square root of 4 is 2. So we get plus or minus 2 square root of 62 all over negative 4. And they both have a common factor of 2, so I'll take that out. So this could be written as a plus or minus the square root of 62 over negative 2, or plus or minus the square root of 62 over a positive 2. And the reason why I can do that is because the negative 2 in the denominator will flop the signs in the numerator, so you still get the same actually answer. whether you have a plus or minus for your two or not.